We are given two graphs and eight equations or eight functions. We want to match the correct equation with the correct graph. Notice all the equations are in the form of f of x or y equals a times b to the power of x plus k. Recall if b is greater than 1, we have exponential growth. If b is between 0 and 1, we have exponential decay. The value of k shifts the graph up or down and affects the horizontal asymptote. If k is positive, the graph is shifted up k units. If k is negative, the graph is shifted down k units. And now let's talk about how the value of a affects the graph of the exponential function. If the absolute value of a is greater than 1, we have a vertical stretch. If the absolute value of a is between 0 and 1, we have a vertical compression. And if a is negative, we have a reflection across the x-axis, or a vertical reflection. So for example, if we graph y equals 2 to the power of x, we have the blue graph, which is exponential growth. Notice the graph is increasing. If we now graph y equals negative 1 times 2 to the power of x, the exponential growth function is reflected across the x-axis or vertically, which gives us the red graph. Notice after the reflection, the new function is decreasing. And now let's look at the reflection of an exponential decay function. In blue, we have the graph of y equals 1 half to the power of x, which is decreasing. If we now graph y equals negative 1 times 1 half to the power of x, the graph is reflected across the x-axis or reflected vertically, which gives us the red graph. Notice now the graph is increasing. This should be enough information for us to match the correct equation to the given graphs. Looking at the graph on the left, first notice the horizontal asymptote is y equals negative 3, which means the graph has been shifted down 3 units. Looking at the graph on the right, notice the horizontal asymptote is y equals 3, which indicates the graph has been shifted up 3 units. And now going back to the graph on the left, notice neither graph resembles the basic exponential growth or decay functions we're used to seeing, and that's because both have vertical reflections. If we take a look at the graph on the left, if we were to reflect this vertically, the shape of the graph would look like this, which should remind us of exponential decay. This indicates the red graph, or the graph on the left, is exponential decay with a vertical reflection. And now looking at the graph on the right, if we reflect this vertically, notice the shape of the graph would look like this, which should remind us of exponential growth. This indicates the graph on the right of the blue graph is exponential growth with a vertical reflection. This information should be enough for us to find the correct equations. Going back to the graph on the left, because we have exponential decay with a vertical reflection, exponential decay indicates that b is between 0 and 1. Because we have a vertical reflection, a is less than 0 or negative. And because the horizontal asymptote is y equals negative 3, the graph has been shifted down 3 units and k equals negative 3. Looking at the graph on the right, because we have exponential growth with a vertical reflection, exponential growth indicates that b is greater than 1. Because we have a reflection across the x-axis or a vertical reflection, we know a is negative or less than 0. And because the horizontal asymptote is y equals 3, we know k equals positive 3. The graph has been shifted up 3 units. Looking at the equations in the first row, because the base b is equal to 2, we know we have exponential growth, and therefore an equation from the first row must give us the blue graph or the graph on the right. So we're looking for an equation where b is greater than 1, which is all of them, a must be less than 0 or negative, which narrows it down to the first or second equations, and then finally, because k equals positive 3, the second equation should be the correct equation. So this should be the correct equation, but let's verify this by selecting two points on the graph and making sure the equation would give us those points. Let's use the y-intercept of 0, 1, and let's use the point negative 1, 2. So when x is equal to 0, notice the y value is y equals negative 2 times 2 to the power of 0 plus 3, which is negative 2 times 1 plus 3, which is positive 1. This point is on the graph. And now we'll use x equals negative 1. When x is negative 1, y is equal to negative 2 times 2 to the power of negative 1 plus 3. 2 to the power of negative 1 is equal to 1 half, giving us negative 2 times 1 half plus 3, which is positive 2. And this point, again, is on the graph. Let's go ahead and label this graph with the correct equation. And now let's look at the graph on the left, which again we know is exponential decay with a vertical reflection and a horizontal asymptote of y equals negative 3, which indicates we're looking for an equation where the base is between 0 and 1, which would be all the equations in the second row, but a must be less than 0 or negative, and k is negative 3. Which should indicate the second equation, once again, should be the correct equation for the graph on the left. Again, let's select two points on the graph and verify we would get those points from the equation. Let's use the y-intercept of 0, comma, negative 5, and let's say this point here of negative 1, comma, negative 7. So when x is 0, y is equal to negative 2 times 1 half to the 0 minus 3, which is negative 2 minus 3, or negative 5, which is the y-intercept. And now let's determine y when x is negative 1. Y is equal to negative 2 times 1 half to the negative 1 minus 3. Recall 1 half to the negative 1 is equal to 2 divided by 1 to the first. Which gives us negative 2 times 2, which is negative 4, minus 3, which is negative 7. And once again, the point is on the graph, and therefore the equation is correct. Let's go ahead and label the graph with the correct equation, which is y equals negative 2 times 1 half to the power of x, minus 3. I hope you found this helpful.